The earth move over the weekend. If you live in Collier County, you may have.
Yeah, a number of our viewers contacted us about the explosions that sounded like sonic booms, and the sheriff's office was flooded with calls on Sunday. NBC2's Rick Ritter found out what it was.
Shockwaves sent throughout Collier County.
It was definitely the equivalency of a sonic boom.
East Naples resident Kevin Heisler had never heard anything like it.
I was out back with my wife, sitting on a lanai, and all of a sudden just boom.
These boom-like noises are the talk of the town, ones that just about everyone heard on Sunday.
I kind of heard a slight rumble, and then I heard a louder rumble, and then my windows started to shake.
The Collier County Sheriff's Office says they received dozens of phone calls around 11 a.m., one after another.
Collier County Sheriff's Office, Deputy Sheriff's Office, how may I help you?
I live on 3rd Avenue Southwest, and about 15 minutes ago, there was a huge explosion. It, like, shook our sliders and shook part of our house.
All asking the same question.
Two loud booms we heard coming southwest of Marco Island. Is that sonic booms or someone blasting?
Less than 2 weeks ago, the Naval Air Station in Key West had jets training over the Gulf, something that contributed to the earth's shaking. But representatives say they had no training on Sunday. Many thought it could have been blasting. Minto Communities, a company developing the new Isles of Collier Preserve in East Naples, has a permit, but officials there say they only blast during the week.
I heard two blasts living down on Marco Island on Sunday, and those have nothing to do with anything that we're doing up in Naples.
With both jet training and blasting out of the question, Sunday's earth-rattling noise remains a mystery for now.
It is what it is.
In Collier County, Rick Ritter, NBC2.
Submerged tombs in Leeville, Louisiana give new meaning to the expression a watery grave. Piles of barnacle-covered bricks washing away in the lapping water. All that remains of a family cemetery in the small coastal town.
All over South Louisiana, you have these little family plots that people had their family members build there. Many as 20 or 30 grave sites, some as many as 60, built on high land.
Wendell Curall manages the South Lafourche Levee District. He's also a descendant of those who once called Leeville home. His ancestors buried here at the Crosby family plot, a patch of crumbling graves along Highway 1 enclosed by a rusty chain link fence. Little protection against the environmental threats that inch closer every year.
The graveyard was in the shade of oak trees, and now you don't see an oak in sight. All you see is marsh and open water.
10 years ago, the family cemented over the graveyard, hoping to preserve whatever was left. But as you can see from the broken tombstones and grave markers, it offered little protection against the rising waters.
Over the past century, the town has subsided roughly 3 feet and lost another from rising sea levels. The cause? Our intricate levee system that prevents flooding. Sediment that built up the delta over 5,000 years now dumps right into the Gulf. As the coastline erodes from hurricanes and storms, there's nothing to build it back up.
Adding on to those problems is that we've cut channels that allows the Gulf of Mexico to get closer to us. We've lost our marsh barriers, we've lost our natural chenillas, our Oak Ridge barriers. All these things help keep some of the energy from storms away from us.
As a result, Curall says the coastline is now 30 to 40 miles closer to the residents of South Louisiana. Families like his own are forced to move further inland with each generation.
And it's like most deltas throughout the world. You always have great risk and great opportunity. And in this place, you have the extreme of both of them. You have tremendous truck traffic, we have tremendous tug traffic and barge traffic, and yet the risks are taking even the graves away.
In the case of Curall's family plot and the other small graveyards dotting Leeville, that risk has taken its toll.
You're not only losing your past, but you're losing your future, you're losing everything.
Once a town of 60, only two families now call Leeville home. Eventually, they too will move to higher ground as they watch the memories of their ancestors sinking before their very eyes.